What happens after we die? Probably the biggest question that humans have been asking themselves since, well, the beginning of time. Some lean towards more religious beliefs, the idea of a god, an afterlife, reincarnation, etc. There are thousands of different viewpoints on this. Others lean towards a more scientific belief that simply nothing happens. There is nothing after we die. But what if we were able to test some of these theories? How would we go about it? In a scientific manner? Most likely. The 2008 film Martyrs has one idea. Welcome back to the most disturbing films ever made. Today we're going to be talking about Martyrs, the French original film, not the 2015 remake. The film starts with one of our protagonists, Lucy, at a very young age. She's escaping some sort of factory where she's presumably been tortured for the past year or so. We then cut to Lucy in an orphanage and meet our second protagonist, Anna, a friend of hers that she grows to cherish quite a bit. However, in the orphanage, we're then introduced to some sort of scarred monster character that seems to attack Lucy at night. She locks her own door, trying to hide from it, to keep it out, but she simply can't. 15 years later, we're then transported to a nice breakfast that is so rudely interrupted by Lucy.
Dimanche, hein? Ta semaine à l'usine.
Lucy first shoots the father through his chest, immediately killing him. She then turns the corner, sees the wife, and shoots her in the back. The daughter tries to escape, and as Lucy's approaching her, she sees the son still in the kitchen. The two have a brief discussion about whether he knew or not what was going on with his parents. And Lucy has this moment of contemplation, if what she's doing is really just. She then proceeds to shoot the son. One last victim in the house, Lucy is hunting down the daughter, who is hiding under her parents' bed. Lucy hops on top of the bed, aiming her shotgun down, and shoots. The daughter panics, crawls out from under the bed as Lucy is reloading, and tries to escape, but she's too slow. Lucy then, in a panic, calls her friend Anna, and these are the people that she believed tortured her all those years ago when she was a child. Anna immediately makes her way to the house to try and help Lucy. They plan on covering up the murder, burying the bodies in a hole the mother was digging earlier. However, the mother is still alive. Anna tries to keep her calm and try and help her escape the house, but before she can, Lucy bludgeons her to death. Lucy then proceeds to get attacked by that scarred creature that haunted her through her childhood. It's graphic in multiple ways, one in the violence and how the creature itself looks, but also and the sound and the visceralness of how it attacks her in such an animalistic way. While Lucy is getting attacked by this creature with a razor blade, we cut to Anna's perspective where she's self-harming herself. This creature is a psychological manifestation Lucy has of her trauma, and we later learn that it embodies a person that Lucy potentially could have saved all those years ago, another poor girl that she knew who was getting tortured. Finally, seemingly having some sort of closure, Lucy then proceeds to slit her own wrists and then her throat, dying in Anna's hands. Anna, still shocked from the previous day's events, then phones her own mother. From their conversation, we can imply that Anna was also abused as a child. She discovers an underground chamber, which means Lucy was right. These were the people that were tormenting her all those years ago. Anna discovers in this chamber another woman named Sarah. She has a piece of metal around her, blinding her, and also numerous scars and wounds. Anna helps her out of the chamber, takes her into a bath, and tries to comfort her to do anything for this poor woman. She then begins to remove the staples that are in her head and try and get off the piece of metal. Safe to say it doesn't go exactly according to plan because skin has grown around this piece of metal from being on it so long. Finally, Anna has some time to mourn for her friend Lucy until she walks in on Sarah trying to cut off her own skin from her arms. Anna is trying to help Sarah, but then she is shot in the head by an unknown group that is now in the house. Now, Anna is captured, and we meet our main antagonist of the film, only referred to as Mademoiselle. Mademoiselle then explains to Anna what exactly their goal is. She has a belief that martyrdom is how one can perceive God or the afterlife. The Mademoiselle shows Anna pictures of supposed martyrs as they're about to die, looking up at the sky, suffering immense amounts of pain. The Mademoiselle then explains to Anna that martyrdom is much more common apparently in women, which is why that's who they choose to murder. And Lucy was only able to escape because of how unorganized they were back then. For an undetermined amount of time, Anna is now going to be tortured until she is able to achieve martyrdom. They force feed Anna, they beat her, they shave her head, they do all sorts of things to break her. Until Anna eventually stops responding to this. So naturally, just when you think it can't be any worse, they take Anna into a separate chamber with a surgeon, and she is then flayed alive, removing all of the skin except for on her face. Once this is done, however, one of the group members informs the Mademoiselle that Anna may be at the final stage of martyrdom. The Mademoiselle comes down and tries to speak to Anna, asking her what she sees. Anna then leans over to the Mademoiselle, whispering something in her ear that we can't hear. The Mademoiselle calls every single member of their group to this house for her to present what she's heard. As dozens of cars arrive, we're shocked at how large this organization is, only imagining how many people they've done this to. As everyone waits in anticipation, the Mademoiselle's assistant speaks to her through the bathroom door. He asks if what Anna said was clear, and she responds yes. She asks if he can imagine what happens after death. Seemingly confused, but he responds no. When her assistant answers no, she simply responds with, "Keep doubting." She then pulls out a revolver and shoots herself in the head. That's how the film ends. Martyrs is widely considered in the horror community as a masterpiece, and rightfully so. However, this is definitely a film I recommend watching, not even just for horror fans, if you can stomach the violence. I just want to thank you all for watching this review, and I hope you enjoyed it. Down in the comments section, leave any films that you recommend, and I'll be happy to check them out, and hopefully cover them in the future. But as for now, this is The Most Disturbing Films Ever Made.